What is going on YouTube? It's Diver, and today we're going to be taking a look at sound whoring in Black Ops 3, and if it's prevalent, if it's a problem, and will they keep it or do something about it? So, without further ado, let's get on with the video. Now, if you don't know what sound whoring is basically using the perks provided by Treyarch, Infinity Ward, Sledgehammer, whatever perks they provide that amplify and enhance your ability to hear and listen to enemy footsteps. Now, using those perks to your advantage will give you an opportunity to slay and a better advantage over your opponent because you can tell where they're coming from just by ear. For example, if I'm running the perk Awareness and Dead Silence and the enemy is not, I can hear him from a good distance away, know where he's going, where they're coming from. If they're planting a bomb, calling in a score streak, capturing an objective, I can hear all that. And that's basically what sound whoring is hearing your enemy and using their footsteps, their actions, to locate them and track them down and kill them. Now, sound whoring isn't easy. With sound whoring, you must have good equipment. Now, what I mean by that is physical equipment in real life, not equipment in the game. You must really run with a good headset. Now, personally, right now, I'm using the standard Xbox headphones headset that was like $50 at GameStop because my Tritons broke. But I am getting Astro A40TRs because, you know, they're cool, they're expensive, but that's what the pros use. They have really good audio quality, really good mix amp, chat volume. They just outdid themselves on this. Can't wait to get a pair and can't wait to use them. But like I said, be sure to get yourself a good pair of headphones. I recommend Tritons, Astros, Turtle Beaches, and even the standard Xbox headset will suffice. Now, you must run the correct perks if you really want to sound whore well. But if you want to go really advanced sound whoring, tracking, and locating an enemy, I'd recommend using Sixth Sense, Dead Silence, and Awareness. But personally, I run Ghost, Dead Silence, and Awareness for those fast hands, but that's not really included in the sound whoring tips. Now, running Dead Silence and Awareness is almost on every single one of my classes. If I don't run Awareness, I'll always have Dead Silence and maybe an extra perk or extra attachment on my weapon. But sound whoring is key to when it comes to using competitive Call of Duty or even just a public match of S&D. Now, in Search and Destroy, sound whoring is a bit different just for the fact that you can hear people pick up the bomb, drop the bomb, plant the bomb, and defuse the bomb. So it gives you a really big advantage is when it comes to killing an enemy and defusing the bomb, especially if you're the last alive. Now, sound whoring also gets you a lot of kills, even in random game modes such as Team Deathmatch, Domination, Kill Confirmed. You can hear enemies coming around the corner, throwing grenades, calling in score streaks. Like I said, you're gonna hear a lot of stuff that you wouldn't hear before. Now, of course, headsets aren't the only thing that do it. There are a couple of things that will help you get the best and most enhanced audio quality that you can. Now, if you go into your game settings and click on the audio selection, you'll find that Treyarch has offered a wide variety of sound improvements and different ways that you can hear in the game. Personally, I use Bass Boost, but I used to use Sound Crunch, or Super Crunch rather, instead of the original Treyarch mix. Now, if you want to play around with them and see which one you like, it will definitely make your gaming experience different, and you will definitely hear a drastic difference in the audio quality. But it'll also give you an idea of what sound whoring is like and basically how to do it. Now, a lot of people don't like sound whoring, and they think it should be taken out of the game. But sound whoring is basically your ears if you don't have the eyes. And what I mean by that is a lot of people in Black Ops 3 run Sixth Sense. Personally, I don't like Sixth Sense. It's basically a counter to sound whoring. But a lot of people don't realize that. They just see sound whoring as an evil part of the game that shouldn't be in there. Sound whoring's been around since as long as I could remember. Since Call of Duty 4, it's been around. People can hear footsteps and just assume that an enemy's around the corner, pre-fire, get the kill. Now, I'm pretty sure that a lot of people's TVs and monitors that they use to play Call of Duty on, or any other game for that fact, will have an option on their physical monitor that gives you the option to enhance your audio quality even further. There are a lot of things that you can do to enhance your audio quality to get you better equipped to sound whore. Now, sound whoring is also very useful when it comes to getting streaks, because when you're close to that last streak, you're close to a mothership, hater, wraps, GI unit, you're close to a streak that you really want to get. You can basically just chill, play it slow, and listen for people. Personally, I love sound whoring. I think it never should be taken out of the game. I think it always should be in Call of Duty, and I can't wait to see how Infinity Ward deals with sound whoring in their next game, 2016 Call of Duty. Hope you enjoyed the video. Remember to give it a big thumbs up. Remember to go check out the channel, if you like the content, please click that subscribe button. I really appreciate it. But above all else, have a nice day. Peace!